Alrighty, today we're taking a look at a septic system from 2012. Right here we have our snake line. That's going to be the access point outside of the home to the sewer line, just in case a clog gets in there. There's additionally one inside of the home, but that's used in case something gets clogged outside and you've got sewage water backing up, rather than opening that up in your basement and having debris and all sorts of fun stuff get there. You're able to open this one outside, keep everything outdoors. So from there, we have a two-chamber tank. This particular setup is going to have a manhole riser on the front and a 6-inch clean out on the back. All of the tanks in our area that are two chambers are going to have these large lids, just like this. Not a huge fan of this style of lid, just because those plastic handles tend to get brittle over time. They eventually start to break, and then getting the lid out really kind of sucks. So I usually recommend stick with the metal ones if possible. So two chamber tanks, right? We're gonna have that one over there, this one over here. This is our front chamber. This is our primary collection place, right? So majority of the debris is gonna go into here. Whenever you flush a toilet, run a sink, bathtub, you name it, all of that solids will come in. It'll hit that front baffle right there, and then the solids will separate out. The heavier stuff will float to the top as your scum. The heavier stuff will go to the bottom as your sludge. Lighter stuff will go up top as your scum, and you'll have your liquid layer in the middle. In the middle of this tank is going to be a thing called a baffle. What that baffle does is it prevents any of the floating scum from reaching the second chamber over here. So if we look inside, we can see that the top of the water is far clearer in the second chamber than it is in the first. We've already looked, the wall baffle's good and in place. The goal of a two-chamber tank is to slow down the volume of debris working its way into the drain fields and should hopefully extend the life of your whole total system. Super important when you do have these kind of systems that you pump both this side and that side at the same time whenever you do your normal maintenance. We usually recommend anywhere from 2 to 5 years, depending on how many people are occupying the house and what the house is being used for. These types of tanks are gonna be pretty much required on all new installations in our area. Nowadays, all systems will come with the two manhole risers versus the manhole riser and the clean out. The reason why is the 6-inch clean out is going to be a little bit smaller, so a 4-inch pipe from the pumper's pump truck will be able to fit in there, but they're not going to be able to do a super great job getting all four corners of that rear chamber. The front chamber is going to be 1,000 gallons, the rear chamber will be 500 gallons, and total, it'll have 1,500 gallons of total capacity. So as the water comes in, the solids will separate out, but you need to deal with that in some way, shape, or form. And that's where we get into our pump chamber. So the pump chambers will usually come in a variety of shapes and colors and sizes. For this particular one, you know, pretty standard. We have our electrical connections outside of the pump chamber, which is great. You have your separate float tree, which is gonna be where all those floats right there connect to, and then you'll have your pump line. So how this works is you will have the water from the tank go into here. The floats will go up and down just like the sump pump would. That'll engage the pump, and the pump will pump the wastewater over to the drain fields right over there. The reason why you'll see this is whenever you have elevation issues on a property, it's easier to have the pump it up to where it's got to go versus digging super deep trenches and running the risk of, you know, additional weight collapsing those pipes. So the pump chamber has a high water alarm, which is that black float right there. Usually we recommend these for all pump chambers, that if you have one, you should have an alarm, so that way you know when the mechanics of the pump are no longer working. In our area, you're required to have this manhole riser accessible at grade over top of all pump chambers. That's the way you can actually maintain it, swap out the pump, and get to it when something goes wrong. If this pump fails for whatever reason, if you don't address it, you run the risk of sewage coming back into your house and causing issues in your basement. From there, the water will then be pumped up into the distribution box, and these are the observation ports on the trenches. A drain field is just going to be, in this particular property, 2 feet wide by about 10 feet deep by about 50 feet long. These are just observation ports, so that way as they age, you have a good idea, like a sight glass, as to what's going on inside of the trench. So these trenches will be quite long, kind of like a French drain. They'll backfill it with number 2 limestone and a perforated pipe. From there, all of the water that's pumped from the pump chamber will go to the distribution box, which is this little white pipe right over here. The box, its sole purpose is to slow everything down. And then from there, the water will evenly disperse into the trenches. So we can see here that the pump's engaged. We've got water flowing into the box and dissipating into the drain fields. in our area, generally drain fields will last for anywhere between 30 to 40 years, sometimes a little bit longer, sometimes a little bit shorter. The best way to get more longevity out of your absorption system is to make sure you pump out your tank, and make sure you're not putting stuff down there that doesn't belong down there, such as grease, venom products, plastic, cigarette butts, etc. These pipes right here are meant so that way if you do have a problem, rather than hoping that you can find the distribution box, you can pop this open and see exactly what's going on. The reason why you'll see this specifically on systems with pump chambers is once you have a pump chamber, you could put that liquid anywhere on the property. And these boxes are usually only 18 by 12. So if you have a really tiny concrete box in a 3-acre field, it's like looking for a needle in a haystack. So the only way to find it would be to dig up the yard, follow the line until eventually you find it, which is quite disruptive to the homeowner. So whenever you have these, don't cut them down to where you can't find them. They do serve a purpose. You may not ever need to open it, but it will help you at some point in the use of your septic system. In our area, you're not allowed to build over top of these so that way you don't compact the soil or potentially crush any of these devices. It's important to make sure that you get this looked at every few years. A good pumper in our area should be taking a peek inside of here just to make sure that nothing squirrely is going on and to notify you in case something started to change so that way you can get on top of it. If you like content like this, please go ahead, give me a like and subscribe, as I will have more content involving the world of well and septic coming out daily. If you have any questions or subject matters you'd like me to go ahead and cover, please leave a comment and I will get to those as soon as I can. Thanks.